डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस लॉरेंज फोर्सेस। क्वेश्चन इज दिस कि व्हाट इज दिस वेरी लॉरेंज फोर्स। वी कैन से दिस वेरी फोर्स, नॉलेज अबाउट दिस वेरी फोर्स इज गिवन बाय मिस्टर लॉरेंज। दैट्स वाई इन द ऑनर ऑफ हिज नेम दिस वेरी फोर्स इज नोन एज लॉरेंज फोर्स। There are two types of Lorentz forces: electrical Lorentz force and magnetic Lorentz force. Come over these two things one by one. First, come over electrical Lorentz forces. We used to say that when we place an electric charge in an electric field, जब किसी electric field में एक electric charge को रखते हैं, then it experiences a force. And value of the force is equal to F equal to Q into E, where Q is the amount of charge present over the charged body and E is the strength of electric field in which it is placed. It means that charged particle will experience force F equal to Q into E. This very charged particle may be static, may be movable. In both cases, this very force will act. And when this very force will act, then according to Newton's second law of motion, means from formula F equal to m into A, we can write A will be equal to F by m, which will be equal to QE by m. It means that due to action of this very force, acceleration produced in the particle will be QE by m. Right? Now come over magnetic Lorentz force. We used to say when we place a movable charge in a magnetic field, it experiences a force. अगर किसी charged particle को which is movable in nature, we place that in a magnetic field, then again that very charged particle experiences a force. Question is this: what will be value of that very force? Then we used to say value of that very force is equal to F equal to Q V cross B, where Q is the amount of charge placed over the charged body and V the velocity with which your charged particle is in motion, and B is the strength of magnetic field in which it is placed. Here we have vector product of V and B. It means that this very force, as it is well known fact to you all that force is a vector quantity, so here magnitude will be equal to F equal to Q V B sine theta, and its direction will be obtained by using rule V cross B. Here charged particle should not be static, because when charged particle will be static, then V will become zero, so force will become zero. It means that magnetic force will be experienced by the charged particle only when it will be in motion. So it should be always movable in nature. Yeah, always movable in nature hona chahiye. It means that when a charged particle is placed in a region of electric as well as magnetic field, अगर किसी charged particle को एक ऐसे region में रखा जाता है जिसमें कि electric field भी हो और magnetic field भी हो, then that very charged particle will experience a force which is equal to F equal to QE plus Q into V cross B. Here QE is electrical Lorentz force and Q into V cross B is magnetic Lorentz force, and collectively these two forces are known as Lorentz force. It means that when we place a charged particle in an electric field as well as magnetic field, then that very charged particle experiences Lorentz force which is equal to QE plus QV cross B. Right? Now come over some special cases. Here we have three vectors: force of the charged particle, velocity of the charged particle, electric field and magnetic field. question it, and all these are three are vector quantities. First case is when V, E and B will be collinear. जब तीनों collinear होंगे, when they will be along the same line, when they will lie along the same line, when their direction will be along the same direction, then we used to say charge particle will move either parallel or anti-parallel to the field. You can divide it into many cases. Let us suppose E and B both are along the same direction. मान लो कि जो है E और B दोनों same direction में है, along right direction, and velocity is also along right direction. Then first come over electrical Lorentz force, as V is along the field along E, so F will be equal to Q into E. And V and B also along the same direction, so magnetic Lorentz force will be F equal to Q V cross B, which is equal to Q into V into B into sine theta. Here theta is zero, so magnetic force will become zero, means magnetic force will be absent. So charged particle will experience only magnet electric force, and which is equal to Q into E, and motion will be along the direction of the field. You can take another case, dono electric field or magnetic field ko right side mein kar do, velocity ko left side mein kar do, then what will happen? Magnetic force will be zero, there will be only electrical force, and velocity is along the left direction, but force is along the right direction. So initially velocity will decrease at a particular time, its velocity will become zero, and after that again it will move along the field. In each and every case you can divide it into many cases, E along one direction, B along opposite direction, and V along the direction of either E or B. In all cases particle will move along the direction of the field. So means particle will experience force along the field, so acceleration will be also along the field, and that very acceleration will be equal to A equal to F by M, which is equal to QE by M. Right? Now come over second case. Your second case is when V, E and B are mutually perpendicular to each other. The velocity of the charged particle, electric field and magnetic field all are perpendicular to each other. जब तीनों perpendicular के केस तीनों होगा जो है perpendicular होगा. Question is this, in that very case what will happen? Then we used to say in this case if your charged particle is experiencing force along one direction, then magnetic force will be experienced by the charged particle in opposite direction. It means that both forces will act opposite to each other, and at a particular case when both forces will be zero, at that time net force experienced by the charged particle will become zero, and particle will move along the direction of the velocity without any deviation. Right?